Food is an essential part of human life. It's what keeps us alive, it's the fuel for our bodies. And that's why so many people take it for granted. Food can be minimized as a necessity or a chore, while good food can go unappreciated. Yet food helps us build connections. Food brings people together to build a community. The food they make, how they make it, and how they share it is all examples of the culture it originates from. In this documentary, we're taking a hands-on approach to learn more about the food in conjunction to Black history by holding a competition where students cook staple dishes in the Black community. Today, through experience, we will find out exactly how foods hold us together and help us carve out a community.
So what dish are you guys most excited for?
Mac and cheese and jambalaya.
Mac and cheese is a must-have when talking about Southern dishes or soul food, but its creation is often overlooked. The mac and cheese we know today was created by a slave named James Hemming. He had the opportunity to go to France and train as a chef, where he was introduced to the mac and cheese of the 1700s, but he remade it and brought the recipes back to the States, cementing the dish and Black innovation into American history.
The roux looks really good. It smells so good. I like jambalaya though. I like the shrimp and the sausage, the kielbasa, and the chicken.
What is jambalaya?
It's chicken, sausage, and shrimp with rice all mixed together and seasonings and like peppers, everything.
Roux and stuff like
that.
Yeah,
where is it from though?
New Orleans.
Creole.
It's real. Jambalaya originated in Louisiana and is an example of Creole cuisine. Creole culture is the mixing of different cultures to make an entirely new one. There's Creole culture in Brazil, the Caribbean, and many more places. When you follow the origins of Creole dishes, you'll find it takes influence from Western European countries like France and Spain. But there's also an overwhelming connection to the food in Africa. There is especially apparent when you remember that enslaved people were the ones in charge of growing, making, and preparing food. In the case of jambalaya, it has obvious similarities to West African dish called jollof.
So no one's excited about the collard greens? I really like collard greens, so I feel like I would be picky about it. You know what I mean? I feel like they can either go downhill very fast if you don't know how to make them right.
Collard greens are similar to mac and cheese since they're both closely tied to soul food in African American culture. But both dishes originated in Europe. Its association comes from the way its cooking habits are reminiscent of those in West Africa, since collard greens were one of the few crops slaves could grow for themselves. And ultimately, cooking traditions and recipes have been passed down through the generations, influencing people all over the South.
Now that we've talked to our judges, let's go see what our cooks are doing in the kitchen.
She said, let's make lobster mac and cheese. I'm Adriana James. I'm the vice president of the BSU and head of step team. So today I'm on side dishes. I'm doing collard greens, which I've never cooked before. So I'm going off of a recipe that you gave me, but I'm adding my own seasonings and all that. And I'm also on baked mac and cheese. Don't come for me. That mac and cheese is gonna come out real good. I got Shanila doing the cheese sauce for me.
My name is Tyler. I'm in 10th grade. I enjoy cooking. This is my first year in BSU. I just transferred to Freeman last year. I want to go to culinary school because I was raised around cooking. Cooking is just my safe place. So I just want to grow up and just become a chef.
All right. Keep it together, y'all.
Hold on. I love that mac and cheese.